to step it up, this life shit crucial. I had to stop worrying about the shit I was used to. Moving, she black and Peruvian. I'm a real Mac and it's proven. Watch how I do. You know what I'm saying? Big telescopes and shit, you know what I'm saying?
Cut it, DJ. I appreciate y'all for coming out to this Young OG show. Y'all looking good as a motherfucker in here. Y'all make some noise for yourself. You know, me and Teddy started this Young OG show 3 years ago at this same location. We wanted to do it because I kind of felt like, we both felt like, you know, we was overlooked and wasn't appreciated, you know what I'm saying? So we was trying to pitch it to, you know, pitch it and, you know, get shows together, you know, but we took the route of saying, fuck pitching it and all that, let's just do our own shit, you know what I'm saying, and do it independently. So we came together and we did it here, and, you know, Teddy felt, he felt love, but he felt like sometimes he wasn't supported by many at times, and this is one of the shows that we created in the first show we did. I knew it was his city, and I was like, Teddy, you should headline it, because it's your city, you feel me? And he headlined it, it was a sold-out show, and he told me, he was like, this show damn near brought tears to his eyes, you know what I'm saying? Because it was the first time in L.A. he felt he got the credit and respect he deserved, you know what I'm saying? So, for sure. So, to see everybody in here, it don't really feel like no fake love or nothing. It really feels genuine, and I'm glad to see everybody here because when he was live, we was packing this bitch out. You feel me? Oh, mama. So it's gonna be tough for me, you know, because you know, this is the first time I'm gonna do this show. Well, let me not say that. I'm not doing this show alone. His spirit with us. You understand me? You know, so his spirit was so positive and everything, you know what I'm saying? I relied on it so much when he was here. Well, you know, so now he gone. Now that's all I got. So, you know, I'm feeling, this is weird because I'm up here having this moment. So bear with me if I just stumble over my words because I'm just speaking from the heart. And, yeah, you know, so I co-hosted this show. Well, not co-hosted, created the show, and I had me and Teddy host together, and we switch, you know, so every time I bring up a comedian, I bring one up, and then Teddy would come, and he bring one up, so it's just odd that, you know, I'm going to bring somebody up here tonight, and my boy ain't going to come up here and bring the next person up, so it's just, I'm just glad everybody here, and I feel the love, and I got oh, I'm forgetting something, man. That's why my spirit a little off. One second. Hold on. I know this is not. Hold on. DJ, play something.
Nah, my nigga, this is dedication. This is anti-hesitation. This is a real nigga celebration. It's a dime block declaration. 59th and 5th Ave, granny house with vanilla wafers. It's the remedy to separation. Tupac of my generation. Blue pill in the fucking matrix. Red rose in the great pavement. Young black nigga trapped and he can't change it. Know he a genius, he just can't claim it. Cause they left him no platforms to explain it. He frustrated so he get faded. But deep down inside he know you can't fade him. How long should I stay dedicated? How long till opportunity meet
preparation? LA hat, man. LA legend, man. If you knew one thing about Teddy, you would never see him without that LA hat. You feel me? So what I want to do is keep this hat up here the whole show. You know what I'm saying? I know comedians be wanting to tell jokes and you the stool, but let's try to do the whole show without this. Oh, we can put it right here. I'm putting it right here. So Teddy be on stage while I'm on stage with me. You feel me? All right, so we here. I feel like I know everybody in this room, we done cried enough. You feel me? Everybody dropped their tears. I've been laughing and crying all week. So tonight, it's all about laughs, and we're going to have a good time because I know Teddy was about a good time, and he was about laughing, all right? So let's do this shit. Y'all ready to start this show? All right, my name is Lewis Belt. I'm the host of the night, man. Okay. And I want y'all to keep y'all energy high and show a lot of love. I handpicked this lineup. This is people that really people that Teddy really fucked with and had a good relationship. You know what I'm saying? So everybody that's touching the stage is a real loved one, and it was deeper than comedy with these people. Teddy done worked with a lot of people. He a motherfucking legend, been on TV and did a lot of shit. But these people I'm bringing to the stage had a personal relationship with him and worked with him, okay? So let's celebrate him like it's Teddy, okay? All right. So let's keep your energy high. By the way, my name is Lewis Belt, you understand me? I'm the host with the most, you understand me? So I'll be back and forth all night. I ain't going nowhere. This first comedian I'm bringing up, man, y'all done seen him. A lot of fans discovered these two at the same time, All Def Digital. You know what I'm saying? They done found it. They the people that we always watching that platform for. Okay, so let's show him a lot of love and start clapping right now. Start clapping right here. He's straight out of Sacramento, man. Give it up for my dog. Dope boy!
Extendos in my Mac, nigga. Spend $1,000 on some t-shirts up in Saks, nigga. I ain't nothing like you fucking rap niggas.
So I wanted to come up here and, you know, because I know what my brother would want me to do. You want me to, you know, come up and, you know, be funny, have a great set, all that good stuff. But I just wrote down a couple thoughts before I got here. And I was just like, you know, I think it'd probably be better if I just kind of spoke that from the heart. And I would always tell Ted, like, because, you know, like, I'm always like a big number person. And I ended up writing 7 different things that I wanted to say. So if that's okay, can I just? All right, I'm trying to get this. All right. I really can't believe that I'm not going to hear that laugh again. Teddy's laugh would make me laugh. He was the most effortlessly talented person I've ever seen in my entire life. Whatever that it factor was, he had an unlimited source of that shit. And when we used to do Teddy versus Doughboy, I used to know that all I had to do was just show up because Teddy was gonna fucking make this shit happen. And we made an entire show, and all I ever wanted to do was beat Teddy, and I could never beat him in shit, and he never gave a fuck about beating me in anything. It was the most ridiculous thing in my life. But the biggest thing is that, you know, the second thing, I don't even have to look at it. The second thing that me and Teddy, you know, I always looked at Teddy like a little brother to me, you know, because I never had a little brother, so he was like a little brother to me, but it was crazy because I looked up to him. And the reason why I looked up to Teddy, because I never really seen Teddy tripping off anything. Like, Teddy could have 66 cents in his account or 6 figures, he was gonna act the exact same way. I'd be like, nigga, you ain't tripping. He'd be like, God got me. I'm going to be all right. And I just loved that about him because I never had that. Like, I would always be tripping, but Teddy just used to inspire me like that. So, okay, those are the two things. Now I want to share a couple me and Teddy Ray stories. Is that okay? Okay, so Teddy introduced me to Chimera right before I got weight loss surgery, right? And he said, Doughboy, if you finna leave the fat nigga community and not be able to eat like this again, we gonna take our EBT cards, put them together, and she gonna make the best fat nigga supper feast ever. And she did. Shout out to Chimera. And, cause me and Ted, that used to be my eating partner. Like, we used to just eat and we ate so good, and that was just one of the biggest memories that I had in my life, was just being able to eat and just chill with one of my best friends. So that was just a really, really great moment. So that's that story. Another story that I have, a little bit of a twist. The first time I went to rehab, Teddy Ray was my my house sitter. And I said, Teddy, I'm gonna go get my life better. All I need you to do is watch the house, okay? And I said, listen, all you gotta do is don't be fucking in my bed, don't sleep in my bed, don't smoke cigarettes in the house, and don't drive the car, because the nigga didn't have a license. I said, unless it's a goddamn emergency, don't drive the car. So he said, okay, cool. So I go to rehab, I'm in there for 2 weeks. For whatever reason, the FBI comes through, they raid the whole place. I'm like, okay, this is a sign from God. I must be supposed to go back to drinking, so. Let me out this bitch. So Teddy's thinking I'm gonna be gone for a month. So I get back to the house. Soon as I get in the room, my bed is all fucking messed up. He's obviously been sleeping in it. There's cigarette butts every fucking where. And he's gone in the car. I'm like, Teddy, where the fuck are you at? He was like, I thought you was getting your shit together. I'm like, nigga, I told you not to drive the fucking car. Bring the car back now. So he comes back and we arguing and I'm like, all right, man, was this the only time you drove the car? He was like, yeah, dude, I didn't drive the car no other time. That was it. 2 weeks fucking later, I get a fucking ticket in the mail. It's from San Francisco. Teddy took the fucking car to San Francisco and he was driving in the pay toll lane and he didn't have his pass. And it was him and Tino in the front seat. I said, Teddy, what the fuck were you doing in San Francisco? He was like, it was a comedy competition in Comedy Central. I had to do it, though. I said, all right, nigga, okay. I couldn't stay mad at Teddy, so. He was like, God's blessings gonna get you one day, though. Don't worry. We'll get you back. Another story I have. When I got married, Teddy was the best man at my wedding. Okay, so Teddy's the best man at my wedding. I go and ask him for the ring. We're getting married at a park in Long Beach. We have a mobile priest. He's like, hurry up, I got another wedding coming up soon. I look to Teddy and I ask him for the ring. He reaches over and whispers in my ear, nigga, do you think God is gonna bless your marriage and you getting married in some Team Jordans? And then he had a straight face and then just stepped back like. And so I got married. The marriage, it lasted 84 days, but the part. Teddy was always so prophetic, wasn't he? So much meaning, the things Teddy would say. But the last thing that I want to say about Teddy, this is one of the things that I remember the most about Teddy before I get out of here. And this is, you know, one of the deeper things that he said to me when we had a conversation. Because Teddy, you know, I don't know if y'all seen over the last like year or so, but Teddy was starting to blow the fuck up. The world was starting to see what we all seen. You know what I'm saying? Teddy was turning down more money than most niggas was getting offered. Teddy was popping, right? And I remember, you know, it was one of the last conversations we had. And Teddy used to always drop gems. But like, you don't know until after, you know, you'll hear it later. Like, he just dropped a bar on me. And so when we was chilling, like, because Teddy, I needed to borrow some money from Teddy. This is one of the first times in my life I ever had to borrow money from Teddy. I used to always hold him down. I said, Ted, man, you can, you know, he was like, man, dog, I got you. You always have me down. So he comes over to the house and we're smoking. And so he gives me the bread. And I'm still just stressing over the financial shit that I'm going through. I'm like, man, this shit's going to be fucked up, da-da-da-da-da-da. He was like, dope boy, shut your bitch ass up. And I'm like, that. I was like, man, why do you always have that calm disposition that you have all the time? Like, because Teddy never cared whether it was up or down. He always just lived. I said, how do you do that? I can't do that. I envy that about you. How do you do that? He said, nigga, because I realized a long time ago, there is more to life than just working all time. I want to quote this right. I don't want to say it the wrong way. He said, because there is more to life than just working all day, paying bills, and then dying. And when he said that, I was just like, it didn't hit me at first, right? I was just like, but it was a bar because now when I look back, you know, and I look at Teddy, Teddy didn't have the regular trajectory of everybody else's life. Teddy was supposed to do something special. Teddy was supposed to be here for the time that he was supposed to be here and impact the people that he did, and I think that bro did that. And he taught me so much the way he lived, and I just looked so much up to him. So I'm sorry, I know my speech was all over the place. I just miss my brother a million. I wish I could hear his laugh one more time. But before I get out of here, any true Teddy Ray fan will know this. And if we could sing this, because I'm going to tell y'all one last true story before I get out of here. In the height of Teddy versus Doughboy, I was taking that shit seriously, right? And when we did the song challenge, shout out to Lewis Bell, we did King of the Sixes, Sonny Bo, and I was like, my song is better than Teddy, this is bullshit. I was like, Russell keeps helping him, he keeps tweeting him, he's not tweeting me. But Teddy's song will forever ring in my head. So if you know the song, I'm gonna say it, and we're gonna sing it together. 1, 2, 3, 4. You and your bitch, y'all ain't gonna work, cause she's cheating on you. And you know it, and you. My name is Mendoza Boy. Thank y'all for listening.
Niggas rap rich, but I've been broke. Last night I had a dream about a kick dope. I used to cross state lines just to get dope. Wanna press my line, gotta fish for it. I'm all alone in the crowd, don't touch
cut
me.
Cut it, cut it, cut it. Give it up for Dope Boy one more time. Dope Boy, man, that you did a phenomenal job. I was impressed. That's impressive. Teddy was in that nigga's spirit. I'm like, this is the best. I said, Teddy is here. Dope Boy killing this shit, man. Dope Boy Teddy, he be like, I be nervous about stand-up, man. I'm good at writing in Bordeaux. I'm like, nigga, this nigga killing right now, man. Y'all feeling the little blue flowers, little roses, right? I think the L.A. hat gonna do everybody good tonight, man. Oh, my, that was some good-ass stories. That's some real shit. Because Ted Wood dropped some gems on your ass, man. For sure, for sure. I'm going to keep this show rolling, though. This shit, that was a phenomenal job. So I'm going to just keep that energy rolling. We gonna follow Doughboy Lee with that one, man. Y'all ready for the next comedian coming to the stage? All right, man. This brother right here, it's crazy because, you know, I'm from the Bay Area, man. You know what I'm saying? So. I struggled with the transition to coming to Hollywood because Hollywood got a bunch of motherfuckers from all over the world and they nerds and rejects from where they from. And they try to act like they niggas. So I don't really identify with a lot of the niggas, but slowly and surely I start realizing the niggas I was really, really cool with was the LA natives. You feel me? Shout out my boy Watts Homie Quan. He in the building, man. Real LA legend. You know what I'm saying? So if it wasn't for Teddy, you know, Watts Homie Quan, my friend Brittany that's here, man, it's some real LA natives that I became friends with because I didn't really know they was from LA. I'm just peeping the energy and the spirit. They was more down to earth. So I'm like, we friends. So this next brother I'm bringing to the stage, man, he a L.A. native, man, and we just connected on our own, and then I peeped that Teddy was real good friends with this brother, and he's a superstar, but he's real down to earth, and, you know, this is a Young OG show. I created this show, and the first person I thought of for this show was Teddy because he a Young OG, young nigga with an old soul, you know what I'm saying? But this is one of our OGs. He ain't a young. He just got so much ism, you don't really know he an OG, you know what I'm saying? But this is one of our OGs, man. Me and Teddy share this brother. He's a part of the family. I consider him as a big brother. So you feel me? Everybody show a lot of love to this brother. He's a living legend, real LA native. Y'all start clapping right now. Show a lot of love. And show a lot of love for the one and only Slink Johnson! Give it up for my nigga Black Jesus in this motherfucker. Yeah! Smoke yours, nigga. Hey, hey. Smoke yours, nigga. Hey, hey. Smoke yours, nigga. Hey, hey. Smoke yours.
Smoking on the bud, feeling kinda high. Sipping on the gin, feeling kinda fine. A Warren G production sits in the tape deck. As Mr. Grim raps, overlaps, don't say shit. Just listen and recline for a spell.
Oh yeah.
What's up, ha ha? What the fuck is up, man? Yeah, man, I'm feeling splendiferous in this motherfucker tonight, y'all. Ain't no tears tonight, man, because we here celebrating my main man, Teddy Ray, and that nigga's spirit was so big, so motherfucking amazing. Anybody in here that Teddy knew, you knew that nigga Teddy personally, consider yourself lucky. Consider yourself blessed, nigga. Teddy had the most kind soul, the most even keel, no matter what was going on in his life, my nigga always was the same way with you. You understand what I'm saying? Teddy didn't let nobody bother him. Niggas would try to bang on Teddy. What's up, cuz? It's Crip. Teddy be like, congratulations, player. Congratulations, player. I'm glad they finally accepted you, my nigga. My nigga Teddy, man, thank God. You know what I'm talking about? And he love to see this motherfucking crowd here because y'all looking good tonight. I swear. Yeah, ain't none of y'all niggas going to jail for that PPP fraud. This look like this type of crowd that got their paperwork right. Shit. What's going on, pimp? Y'all niggas too buff to be sitting at that little ass table together. These niggas in here look like they sitting under a checker. Shit. Crazy out here in the world, you know what I'm saying? All these fucking, they hitting us with COVID and pandemics, and now they got on monkeypox and shit. That shit crazy. Y'all niggas gotta stay safe, man. Be careful, man. I got a condom on right now. You niggas is crazy too. That pandemic shit hit, everybody had on masks. You ain't know how the niggas look for 2 years. Some of you niggas always talking about y'all got all health conscious and shit during COVID and shit, man. You gotta mask up, use that sanitizer. But you niggas still going raw. Having raw sex with a mask on and shit. What kind of logic is that? You want to eat the pussy, you going to lift it up a little bit. What's up, my nigga? I learned something, you know what I'm saying? I didn't get to be this old being dumb, man. I learned something about social etiquette. You niggas, you young niggas be so hard and so thirsty running out here chasing these girls and shit. When you see them, the first thing you're on, what a bitch said, we the bitch. No. I want to acknowledge these niggas because they be the shooters, nigga. You got to humanize yourself with niggas. As soon as you get, hey, brother, how you doing? My name is Gerald. That's all niggas want is a little bit of acknowledgement. You know what I'm saying? I see you out here in your fine ensemble, nigga. You got the little shirt with the cat on it, nigga. I'm sure it's something French. I love you niggas. I love you young niggas, and you know what I'm saying, but you niggas is beginning to scare me a little bit. There's a bunch of y'all in here tonight, no under 30s. All the under 30s, make some noise. 90s babies, make some noise. I love you niggas, but I'm scared of you niggas at the same time. You niggas, man, I love you niggas the most, though, because, you know, niggas know your mamas. My nigga, that woman you so lovingly refer to as mom, she kisses those boo-boos. She be at every fucking school event, caring about you, loving you, and being there for you when your punk-ass daddy didn't. That woman with all that heart and emotion, in 1999, that bitch was a No Limit soldier, my nigga. Nah, 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 nah. Had niggas saying, You ain't know, nigga, your mama used to ride the tank. I remember your mama, yeah, they used to call your mama TT, and she worked at Wiener Schnitzel. She got fired from Wiener Schnitzel and went to Hot Dog on a Stick. That shit was the best shit ever. I used to go to Hot Dog on the Stick every day to see your mama make that lemonade and shit. Titties just bouncing and shit. I know y'all don't like to hear that about your mamas, but I'm just telling you the truth, man. You know, she human. Your little mama, your mama was so hot, my nigga. Your grandma used to try to keep her off the block. You go to work and come straight home. Your mama didn't listen. That bitch out hanging with the Crips in them same shorts she had on all day making that lemonade. I'm just trying to tell you, man, this is just a lesson in respect for you young niggas and the way you're treating these ladies. You know what I'm saying? Ladies, one day you're going to be somebody's mama. You know what I'm saying? You got to give your mama some space and some respect and offer her some humanism. You know what I'm saying? Your mama liked to get hit from the back, too. She was the original hot girl. Your mama came up on Millie Jackson. You youngsters, Google Millie Jackson. Original hot girl. Your mama used to smoke stress. She used to do strange things for the stress. I remember I used to see her come to school. She had a little ponytail on the side and shit. She had a little scrunchy socks with the K-Swiss on. Getting on the 40, on the way to the weed spot. Y'all niggas gotta stop hating on your mama too. She need love too, you know what I'm saying? Like, your mama ain't been with your daddy since she was like four. Since you was like four. She been just taking care of you and shit. So when your mama finally get a boyfriend, y'all quit stepping in and intervening on it. Your relationship with your woman ain't straight either, nigga.
Mama don't like him.
Fuck that, she like him, nigga. So when you see them Stacys by her bedroom door, don't go asking no dumbass questions and shit. Y'all motherfuckers be mad at your mama boyfriend, but y'all don't understand, you know what I'm saying? Them niggas was instrumental in helping you raise your ass, nigga. Your mom, remember that time your mama carburetor went out on a car? Is that bitch a mechanic? Nah, nigga, that was Jeffrey that did that shit. Nigga, you remember you wanted to play football and shit. Your daddy was in prison. Your mom was still working at Wiener Schnitzel. She couldn't afford all them pads. That was Coach Smith. Before I go, I know Teddy loved people. And Teddy really respected women, and I respect women. I love women, and I know this, that women are the most underprotected people on earth. Black women. And that shit, all women, because it's a bunch of y'all in here, because I want to fuck some of these other women too. But I mean, black women are the most unprotected people on earth. You understand me? And that shit got to stop. As an elder statesman, as a real nigga up here, I'm gonna tell something. I got something for the ladies, and I need you to understand this. I gotta take my hat off for this. As a real nigga out here, as a man, as a real Crip in these streets, you hear me? I don't give a fuck, baby. If anybody fuck with you or disrespect you or make you feel like anything less than the queen you are, you hear me? If a nigga put his hands on you, I don't give a fuck who it is. Look, baby, this nigga cat shirt. If cat shirt fuck with you, hey, look, cuz kind of girthy around the bicep, but I ain't tripping. If this nigga fuck with you, any of y'all, ladies, if any of these motherfucking men fuck with y'all, I hope you bitches know how to fight, because you probably was talking shit to the nigga. Hey, look, I'm Slink Johnson, man. Smoke some weed. Rest in peace, Eddie Ray.
Work that.
my nigga. Give it up for Slink Johnson one more time. Real LA nigga, man. That nigga inappropriate, nigga. Oh, mama, Ty. How y'all bitches feeling in this motherfucker? Teddy was a good person. I don't know how to feel, nigga. That show you that Teddy had two sides of him, nigga. Oh, my mama. A lot of people don't know Teddy was a nigga. He'll slap shit out of somebody. He never did it, though. He always just, he'd be like, Lil, I don't like, I can't go around that person. I would slap the shit out. I'd be like, really, Teddy? Oh, mamas. I love that nigga for that shit, man. I'm a person that I'd be like, I wear my emotions on my sleeve, and Teddy never wore his emotion on his sleeve. So I kind of feel like we be needing each other because, you know, Teddy would be around some people he don't like, and I'd just be like, hey, get the fuck from around here, nigga. And he appreciate that. And sometimes, you know, sometimes when I need to shut the fuck up, he'd be like, Lil, it ain't that serious. It's Hollywood. Oh, mamas, nigga. Fought some real demons. This shit crazy. That's some shit I can't even tell y'all up here about Teddy. I love everybody. Oh, what's up, my nigga, man? Good to see you, brother. You got hella chains on, nigga. Shit. You look dangerous. That nigga said, where my chains at? Nigga, not near your thieving ass. Nigga, just... Why you know I got a chain, nigga? Oh, Lou gonna be there? That's how LA niggas stand when they wanna rob you. Hold on, nigga, where you from, huh? Oh, mamas. We gonna keep this show rolling. Are you having a good time? Say hell yeah. Yeah. All right. This next comedian I'm bringing up, I was supposed to bring them up one by one, but they need each other. They kind of like, yeah, they need each other. They kind of remind me of like the female version of me and Teddy. They hilarious and they genuine people. One thing I can say about these two. They got both individual relationships with Teddy, but one of them is a rider for Teddy. They both ride. Now their relationship was tricky, you know. I don't even want to tell them they shit. They say they shit, but y'all already know who in the building, man. I'm going to let them come up and tell their story because they got a lot of stories. And one thing I can say about these women, though, they loyal. These two women is, I don't even know no niggas that's more loyal than them. You know what I'm saying? So outside of them being hilarious, they some real motherfuckers. And they stand on shit. And they really looked out for my boy. You feel me? Teddy Ray really respected them and he loved them. You feel me? I'm getting caught up. I'm trying to stay strong. But my nigga respected them. And these some loved ones, man. They part of the family, man. So I want y'all to make a lot of noise because these is women, so they emotional. Don't be looking at your ass almost start crying because I said women emotional. You better. So I want y'all to show them a lot of love when I bring them to the stage, okay? All right, y'all can do that, ladies. Y'all gotta hold each other down in this motherfucker, all right? All right, so y'all start clapping right now. Show a lot of love for my girl, Precious and Kamira on these hoes.
I'm serious. On these hoes. You love me, do you love me not? Damn, you hit
they
the
come
spot.
To the stage looking like some gangsters with their glasses on and everything.
Like water, can I love on you?
We'll give us all our love, Precious.
Every
day here, I man. Need
a dose. Every now and then I'm missing. I got my times when I go ghost. But she mine. I'm stamping her.
priority status, so them other bitches mad at her. Too mad. Thumbing through 100,000, I spent that times two on you. Call myself, couldn't you lose?
That's that shit. What's up, y'all? Man, this is beautiful, you know what I'm saying? Like, this is beautiful. If Teddy was here, he would be like, okay. Okay, niggas came out. They might have loved the nigga. This is Teddy shit. We're going to be here together, fool, because for real, nobody, I don't care who coming up after this, when nobody closer than Kamira and Teddy, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. Like, in real life. Like, I've been telling her too, bitch, you should have fucked them, you know what I'm saying? God damn, that nigga gone, he could have gave pussy one time, bitch, God. Bitch, we ain't the big sisters like that. Sisters and brothers, you know, if you ain't really got the same mom and dad, that's my brother, you fucked with them, you know what I'm saying? Like, you ain't fucking one time, but I mean, serious face, fool, but that love is real, you know what I'm saying? And like, to me, you know, when I first came out here, I wanted to be around and do all this shit, and then you learn how this shit go, and you see how trash it is and how trash the people is, you know what I'm saying? So when you find them lights, you know what I'm saying? Like, you appreciate them. So I could be out at the club, and it could be a million people there, and I feel nothing. But if Teddy walked through the door, you know what I'm saying? It's like, family, what's up? You know what I'm saying? He was that light. So you know what I'm saying? Shit like that don't die. Like, genuine people with that calm soul. You know, we very ignorant. I try to be calm, ignorant. Kamira is, you know. She is the beast with it, you know what I'm saying? But that's why we balance each other out, you know what I'm saying? But Teddy was the one, and the two, and the three. And I don't care who you is, you couldn't fuck with him, you know what I'm saying? On no scale, and you knew that, you know what I'm saying? But he was very humble with it, and y'all just bear with my nigga, okay? Because it's a lie. But I want y'all, I do want to say, I'll be chilling until somebody else break down, you know what I'm saying? We done got the news. We like, everybody go to Kamira house. You know what I'm saying? We chilling. Slink, everybody over there. We all trying to get the shit together. Kiwan, he got his silent tools. You know what I'm saying? I done came with the drink. We all getting fucked up. You know what I'm saying? I've been on clear and dark. I'm still sober. You know what I'm saying? It's a lot of shit going on, so I'm thinking we doing okay. Next thing you know, who gonna do it, y'all? Goddamn dope boy. This nigga done broke down like Mariah Carey, nigga. This nigga is in sleep chairs. I'm like, nigga. I'm trying to, you know what I'm saying, my nigga? I'm trying to be strong, this nigga. I love dope boy. Shout out to dope boy. That's my nigga for real. But god damn. It was a lot. You know what I'm saying? I'm finna grow up. But Teddy would appreciate that. I told him right then, Teddy would be like, nigga. What are you doing, nigga? Like a 5-year-old. Okay, come here. Take off.
So Precious, I was like, bitch, you gotta come up here with me, cause man, this is a lot. Just to make myself feel better, shout out to the two bitches that Teddy kicked me out the room for. I know y'all thought y'all was important. Enjoy the live stream. I hope it's not buffering. Like, bitch, we are not the same. Huh? We are not the, I'm this nigga emergency contact, bitch. Don't fucking play. Don't. It's my nigga, man. It's, fucking up already. Me and Teddy was. I don't have a lot of friends. You know, if y'all know me, I don't just meet people and be their friend. You know, something got to happen. It got to be a sign. And, no, for real. Or you going to stay away. It's got to be a sign. So with Precious, her birthday is the same day as my best friend of 25 years. So I felt like that was God telling me she cool. And when I met Teddy, he fell in love with me, I think, because I was so L.A. And the nigga gave me so much game the first night I met him, and I couldn't believe he was young. He was like 21. And I'm like, damn, you out here in these streets? And, you know, he was telling me, like, you funny as fuck, but you can't just do L.A. jokes. Because if you want to evolve and go other places, niggas don't know about Crenshaw and shit like that. And I was like, damn, okay. And I'm not used to dating smart niggas. You know, he... like, this little nigga teaching me something, you know what I'm saying? So we were at the Comedy Union. When I left, I seen a nigga walking. So I was like, you walking home? And he was like, yeah. And I was like, nigga, where you from? And he was like, what the fuck? And I'm like, nigga, where you from? And he was like, I don't bang.
You banged on the nigga.
Yeah, I'm like, where you from? Because I'm older than Teddy. I had a kid, all kind of shit. You know, Teddy is like about 10 years younger than me. So, and when I met him, and when I met him, he was like 22. So he was a baby, so. He was like, I ain't from nowhere. I was like, that's the wrong answer, nigga. Get in the car. You feel me? Like, I'll take you home. Like, you, they not gonna listen to that. Just get in the car. So, when he got in the car, swear to God, when he got in the car, he took me to the street I grew up on. And it was the last place I lived with my mom and my dad, and we moved, and I used to beg my mom to take me over there. And even when I got older and I wanted to, you know, I had to rent, you know, I wanted to get my own place or whatever, I went over there to look for a place. It was like my favorite street, and this nigga lived on the street. So I was like, this nigga's supposed to be my friend, you know what I'm saying? Like, that's God telling me, like, you know what I'm saying? And that's why I was Teddy's friend. And I, you know, I didn't know nothing about comedy. I didn't know, you know, who Teddy was. I didn't know he was just this great person. I just knew that, you know what I'm saying? We connected, and he lived on my fucking old street, and this was my nigga. That's it for me. You know what I'm saying? And he brought me to All Deaf. Yeah, like.
And if you gave him some head, we know about it.
Yes.
Yes. Okay.
I didn't even know about All Deaf. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like Teddy, he opened up doors for me and did shit. And I didn't even know that I was gonna do, like, I wasn't, I thought I was funny, I was just trying it, you know what I'm saying? Like, and him just telling me, get on stage, come here, and taking me to open mics and shit, and it just, he why I'm here, you know what I'm saying? So, I just thought, I didn't ever think I was gonna ever end this journey with him, you know what I'm saying? I just thought we was gonna go the long haul. And I'm just mad at this nigga, too. Like, I love him, but I'm mad at this nigga. Like, so you gonna fall asleep in the pool, nigga? You just gone, what the fuck, nigga? But the thing that's divine for me, and this is what I want to say, is that Teddy was so spiritual and he was so close to God. And no matter what he had, he always wanted to uplift people. And my nigga died divinely. He died the way he came. You know what I'm saying? And that shit fucked me up. You know what I'm saying? And that's how he was supposed to go, like the G that he was, like the angel that he was. You know what I'm saying? And I'll forever love him. And I don't even know what I'm gonna do. I really don't even want niggas to talk to me no more. I'm just like,
really don't like none of you.
I know, for real. I'm like, I went to a comedy show and I was listening, like, these niggas' jokes ain't dead, God. What the fuck? Like, this is what I gotta go through. You know what I'm saying? Like when Jay-Z and Biggie died, then we had to listen to Ja Rule, nigga, Ashanti. This is what the fuck we gotta go through now? Like, I don't want this shit. No, I just fucking irritated, bro. Like, fucking start throwing tomatoes at these niggas. Like, I don't know. Just, I'm gonna try to maintain, you know what I'm saying? Just, but my nigga gone, man. That was my nigga. Like, me and Teddy been down a long time, and he's just the sweetest person, and he was just too good for this world. That's just what it was. So, I love him. God bless his family. God bless y'all. Thank y'all for bringing him into the world. Because he made it a better place for every fucking body, and that's it. So,
riding in my car, and I'm listening to the radio. I'm listening to a sad girl sing about how she got her heart broke. People reaching for stars. I just
me something natural.
Give it up for Precious Kamir on these hoes one more time, man. Me and Teddy got a podcast called The Cali Kickback, and for the people that watch it, you know, shout out to all the Cali Kickbackers in the building, you know. Yeah, me and Teddy, we was pushing hard to do this On These Hoes Young OG tour, man, and we was really gonna make it happen, man, so I don't know, that was just like the closest thing we gonna get to it tonight, man, so, you know, I felt good, for sure, we still can do it. All right, I just gotta have my LA hat with me, man. I'll probably be all right. Oh, mamas. Yeah. You having a good time?
Yes, sir.
People in the back, you having a good time? All right, this next guest coming through, she's a superstar, well known. She'd have been on Netflix, got a long resume. She had a lot of love for Teddy. She had a lot of love for what we was doing. She was one of the few people that was at a higher level that actually supported the Young OG show. So it was only right for when I put this show together, it's only right to have her on the lineup. So I want y'all to show a lot of love and start clapping right now. Start clapping right now. Show a lot of love and give it up for my girl, Ida Rodriguez. Show a lot of love, man.
I like diamonds, I like stunning, I like shining, I like $1 million deals. Where's my pen? Bitch, I'm signing. I like those Balenciagas, the ones that look like socks. I like going to.
They always play Cardi when the Puerto Rican bitch gets on stage. That's, so it's like reverse racism. Like. How y'all doing? I just hugged Teddy Ray's mother and I said thank you to her because she gave us that gift. She gave us that gift. I'm a mother and I got some trash ass kids. Like, she gave us a gift and I come up here and do a set because I really am emotional. And I'm not scared to cry, I'm not embarrassed. I love Teddy, and I can express my grief for him without any shame. I can't come up here and, I wish I could do a set, but I don't feel that way. I will say this about Teddy. It's a lot of comedians who are insecure about themselves, and they will project their insecurities onto you, right? I got a bunch of these young bitches that be like, oh, she's my mom, I'm not your mom. I didn't fuck anybody to make you. You look old, so stop trying to date me. Teddy never did that to me, right? Teddy used to call me his colleague. He always treated me like, the last thing Teddy said to me was, I love you. And that to me means so much because uninhibited joy everywhere he went. Everywhere he went, he brought L.A. with him. Yeah. And I'm going to tell you right now, the L.A. people I fuck with are the ones below Wilshire because those are the real ones, right? You know what I mean? Like, I'm from Miami. I'm from the gutter. But I always find the hood when I go somewhere, right? And I used to go to Millennium to take my son to get his hair cut and scare him. I used to take my daughter to get braided up so she wouldn't think she was white because she went to school in Sherman Oaks. You know what I mean? Like I used to go to Earl's over there. Like that was the first community that embraced me when I moved here. Because when I moved here, I was broke and I didn't have anything. And when I was in LA, they treated me like a person, right? Now these motherfuckers be up in your face and you don't know if they real or not because they think you got something. They don't know how much money I owe in student loans. But you know what I mean? Teddy called me Miss Parker. Right? He called me Miss Parker, and I thought he was being fresh. But it was so funny because he always celebrated me. He used to tell people I was his girlfriend, and he's the only comedian I ever claimed as my man. I did. I used to tell people who asked me, you know, because he would say, I'm like, yeah, we go together. And people be like, for real? I'm like, yeah, I've been, me and Teddy been dating since he was in middle school. That's how much of a G he is. He been putting it down, right? I will say this. When I walked up to this comedy club and I saw all the people outside, I said, rightfully so. You know what I mean? Because all we can hope for is that when we graduate from this life and people get together to celebrate what we did, that we would have this turnout. Right? Teddy got a better turnout in his memorial than some comedians in their headlining weekends. You understand? That speaks volumes to who Teddy, I will say, is and not was, because I believe the spirit is forever. Right? I don't believe we die. I believe we graduate. And I'll tell you this. We, as a community of comedy, have had so much loss in the last year, right? Teddy passed away a year after Nick passed away. And we have been just taking these hits. We lost our baby, Serene, because that is all of our baby, right? We lost Fuquan, who used to always be on this stage. Some white comedians, right? Like, we lost Bob Saget and Louie, and I segregate us because they segregate us in comedy. But I love this person. This y'all pass the plate and give her the money. But I was just gonna say that when we get together in loss, we should remember this in life, right? And we should always look at each other. I know there's some white people in here, and that's beautiful. But as people of color, we are under attack on a daily basis. All these young black men we have to, and young black women who are surviving on a daily basis. I'm the mother of a black son and a black daughter. We sit here every day and survive, and I just think it's so important that we remember. We remember in life, not in death, right? Teddy deserves this and so much more. I'm so glad that the world got to see the magic that was Teddy Ray, right? Because I used to see Teddy, and I remember, because Tony did a video, Teddy and Valentino. I was like, yo, y'all finished doing that movie with Jim Carrey? Remember me, him, and Irene? They looked like the two little fat boys. Remember them? They used to roll together, and I was like, they're going to end up in movies together. They're going to kill. But I will say this. I'm scattered because I'm so wounded. I feel so hurt. I have been saying since I heard about Teddy Ray, not Teddy Ray. Not Teddy Ray. Like, he has so much to do. And I believe that he did his work here, and now he's doing his work beyond. Because there's no way you're going to tell me that God, the God we love, that God that's so great, that does all these amazing things, could take Teddy Ray and say it's over. Amen. It's just not possible. That's not what God is, right? God is not limiting. God is not negative. God is good. God knows better than we do. We think we out here living. We think this is the shit. You know what I'm saying? Running, like, oh, we were struggling, pulling out the EBT card, and like, hey, bitch, you know. We think that's living. We like, we don't want to die because we don't know what's beyond. But what I will say, I am so thankful, and I will say thank you again to Teddy's mother for blessing us with that amazing gift. The funny thing is, when I saw her beautiful face and she smiled, I saw Teddy. Yes. Right? Because that's just the, as a mother, I don't, many of us as parents, you can't even fathom what life is without your child. But what I will say is, you have a family and a community of people where Teddy will continue to live on. And I don't know about the rest of them, but you know, I'm reliable. People know I'll show up. I got you. I got you, and I know there's some people in here that got you too. I just want y'all to remember, they told us a lot of lies about ourselves. They had to tell us because we come from some great people. Indigenous and African people are amazing. The kings and queens before slavery. I didn't mean to turn this into this, but I think it's important to remind you who you are. The greatest opponent you can have in life is a man that has nothing to lose. If you love Teddy Ray, if you really love Teddy Ray, then you'll live your best life. Yes. And stop trying to do dumb shit in the name of being cool and fulfilling the prophecy that evil has set out for us, because we are an amazing, beautiful people, black and brown people. We come from the best stock, and no matter how much shit that they've put us through, we are still here. And if you love Teddy Ray, if you love Teddy Ray like I love Teddy Ray, then you will make a decision today to live your best life. We can't lose no more of our soldiers, right? And I will say this. I wish that I could smile and light up a room like Teddy Ray did. I wish that I could walk into a room and have the energy that Teddy Ray had. Lewis needs the support now. Doughboy needs the support now. Precious and Kamira need the support now. Because we all love Teddy Ray, and Teddy Ray loved us all, and we were all cool. But those were the village. So don't forget them in this moment, because his mother needs your support. But like I said, when Teddy showed up for LA, and he showed up on MTV, everywhere he went, All Deaf, he showed up for LA. I expect LA to show up for Teddy Ray. I love you, even if I don't know you. Thank you so much.
Wait, hold up, I'm gonna turn this bitch up. Hello, what the fuck do you want? Hello, stop calling my phone. Hello, what the fuck do you want? Hello, stop calling my phone. Hello, hey, what the fuck do you want?
Cut it, cut it, cut it. Give it up for Ida one more time. A real one. It's Thug Mansion in this motherfucker, I love it. Oh, my mama, a place for all the real niggas can go. Oh, mamas. I'm going to keep this show rolling. We got a family member in the building. We got a lot of family in here, for sure. Everybody's family here, but we got a family member in here that's a comedian. And one thing I learned about Teddy, too, I respected him because I knew he was a real LA nigga, because he had a room that he was doing. I don't know where it's out. I don't want to misquote the location because this shit political out here. But it was in the hood. It was in the hood, hood. Where the family room at? Where the location at? Okay, all right. The family room. If you from LA, you know. You feel me? So it was a little spot where I'm like, ooh, let me get out my jewelry and all that and humble myself to come to this room. And I loved it because it was so authentic. It was a spot where, you know, all the Hollywood motherfuckers were scared to go. And me coming out of Oakland, I was comfortable there. You know what I'm saying? So I respected him for doing that. And alongside of him doing that, he was doing it with his cousin. That's a comedian. And his cousin, his name is Brent Taylor. Brent Taylor, he's in the building. Come here. Where Brent Taylor at, man? Brent, come to the stage. Keep it going for Brent, man. This brother right here, I respected him so much. Oh, yeah, okay. Yeah, I was respecting him so much. You feel me? Because he was the first person I see have some chemistry with Teddy on stage. They was doing the same thing we was doing at the Young OG show. He would, Brent would perform, he'll host, and then Teddy, they'll switch off. And I love that about Brent and Teddy, because I seen that they was niggas that was about the community, and they was unselfish. And that's one thing I respected that. You know what I'm saying? So I spent a lot of time, and that's why I met Brent. That's why I met this man at, you know what I'm saying? So that's just one thing that the people need to know. Because outside of them being cousins, Brent is a talented comedian. Let's go,
and he a loyal person. Real LA nigga, you got anything to say, Brent?
I'm gonna talk. I don't wanna say shit. Motherfuckers is lying about my cousin. Yeah, I'm hearing so much stuff. This is my cousin. I'm hearing things on TMV, YouTube. They saying he got shot. Yeah, they did, yo. I'm his cousin. Even though I'm littler than him. Y'all know I'm his evil cousin. Shit hurt, I'm watching all this shit. And it's lies. I'm gonna tell you why it's lies. Even Teddy would tell y'all it's lies. They said he got shot. Teddy would tell y'all right now, I couldn't get shot. They don't have bullets for me, nigga. You gotta know you about to shoot Teddy. Now you, nigga, they can shoot you with anything. It could bounce off something and hit you. They need a bullet for me. That's why I be in these streets. I used to be like, nigga, really? That's why you not scared of Crips and Bloods, nigga? They can't kill you? You was like a vampire? I taught him how to walk, yo. That's my real cousin, y'all. That's not like a friend or something like that. Like, that's my real cousin, and I remember raising him with my family. So to see that he came out to be the shit, he was the shit, y'all. He hit home runs. He was slam dunking. He was running around the bases, y'all. We all was trying to get the shit this nigga was doing. I just wanted to teach him how to walk, because he was big. I did that. Y'all don't know. He used to come to my house in the valley, big as fuck. I said, cuz, what the fuck is you doing? You don't even have a car. You just mob from LA, nigga, here, swinging your. They gonna think you a big ass auntie. You're a big black man, nigga. What? This is how I walk, nigga. He have his earbuds in, and I snatch him out. Like if Lewis was him right now, I'd be like, I'd walk up like, nigga, what you listening to? I'd be like, the fuck? And I'd listen to it and it'd be Keisha Cole. I said, cousin, nigga, you hopped the train, took an Uber, you like hopped through six hoods, nigga, with Keisha Cole. I think there was nothing wrong with that. I said, well, if you gonna do it, nigga, they don't know you doing it. It's cool. Oh, what's this? Destiny's Child? Is this girl? Hey, keep that shit going, nigga. This that shit, nigga. Girl, you don't have to be hiding. I'm your girl. You my girl. We your girl. Don't you? Dun, 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 dun. That was me, nigga.
We would smoke blunts and listen to Destiny's Child. Oh, mama. We'd be at the table. On God, we'd be at the table rolling big backwoods. You know, I don't know about him. Him been cheating. My daughter would come in. What are y'all doing? Go in the room. Go in the room. Turn that shit back up, nigga. Do you know Cater to You? I like Cater to You too, nigga. Nigga! I think Kelly got the best part. She do, she do. She do. It wasn't about Beyonce, nigga. Kelly got the best part. I want that nigga to walk in a certain way. All jokes aside, I used to really tell that nigga, hey, fuck all that swinging your arms. I know you big, nigga. Big, and you black, and you represent something you don't even fucking know, nigga. Real fucking talk. You represent something you don't even know. Walk with your motherfucking chest up and curve your arms. Don't swing them. Just walk like this, nigga. Y'all know he tried. Look at him right there. That nigga tried. That nigga got his shit out, yo. Banging on. Stick your chest out, Teddy. And let the world know. He did that, man. Thank y'all, man. That's all I wanted to say. I love y'all. Thank you, Louis. For real, man. Thank you, Louis. I appreciate it, man. This mean a lot. My nigga loves you, man. Real talk. And he loved all y'all, man. For real. Thank you, bro. I just wanted to say that. That's it, B.
Give it up for Brent one more time, man. I forgot to tell y'all what year he was at the family room. I thought Teddy was just like a superstar when I came out here, and he was, but I'm like, bro, this nigga in the hood, nigga. I came from Oklahoma. I'm thinking this nigga gonna be in Hollywood. I'm like, this nigga was just in the hood. So I'm a real one, though. You know what I'm saying? I like this nigga. Oh, my mama, so. Yeah, if it wasn't for that family room, I think our relationship would have been different, because I think he learned a lot about me and I learned a lot about him. And just that's why I just love Brent, man. You know, just another round of applause for Brent, man. He for sure. Yeah. How do I want to wrap this up? It's going to be tough, man. This the first Young OG show I did. He here with me. He here with me. He ain't. He here with me. Want some more comedians? Nah, where mom's at? Moms, come to the stage, man. Give it up for Teddy Mom. Everybody stand up. Give a big round of applause to Teddy Mama. Before I hand the mic over, I just want to say, you know, thank you for birthing a good friend of mine, you know what I'm saying, bringing him into this world, you know what I'm saying. You raised him right, you did everything you could as a mother, you did everything, you raised him right. He got a good spirit. His spirit wouldn't be like that if you didn't bring him into this world like that, okay? So, like I said, when I came up with the concept of this Young OG show, and I was like, you know, ran it by Teddy, he fucked with it and all the shit. It was one thing I cared about, opinions. We was like, fuck the industry, we gonna do this shit 100%, you feel me, black on, we mobbing. But the people opinions I cared about the most, is my mom and dad's opinion about this show and Teddy's mother's opinion about the show. And Teddy mom was actually she was actually able to see the show we did in Fresno, and she came out. she came out to the show in Fresno, and she had a good time. She loved our chemistry, how we were so unselfish. I headline the show sometimes. Teddy headline the show sometimes. And she came to me after the show and said, I love what you're doing. I love what you guys doing. You and Teddy got a chemistry and a bond that, you know what I'm saying, that's, you can't just find. And once she told me that, and my mom and dad told me that, and they met each other, it was just like, I just knew it was something deeper than, you know, our friendship in comedy. You feel me? It's something that family. It was just like we went from comedians, friends to family. And you play a big part of that, moms, because once you came to me that day and said you liked it and you appreciate everything we was doing, that meant the world to me and that meant the world to Teddy. So I thank you for that. Yeah. Is anything you feel comfortable to say?
I just want to say thank you all for being here.
Thank you. Thank you.
We love you.
Thank you, mama. Yeah.
So I love each and every one of you. And it was important for me when this all happened. Like Brent said, all the lies and stuff. Y'all sit down.
Mom's getting nervous.
The damn light. I don't know how y'all do it up here. But there were a lot of things that go around. I knew that my son was special.
Yes, he was.
It's not about how you start, but it's about how you finish. I've been clean and sober for 25 years. So if you do the math, there were some of those years of Teddy's life that I was not clean and sober. It's not about how you start, it's about how you finish.
Thanks.
And in that time, his auntie and his cousins and grandmother raised him when I couldn't. And when I got sober, his grandmother made me write a letter. You remember, Jackie? Yeah. His grandmother made me write a letter that if for some reason I didn't stay the course, that I would make sure he went back to where he was going to be cared for. And I stayed the course. But I knew that I had to give my children the same foundation that my mom gave me. And I knew, I mean, he's been down on Skid Row. We went to meetings, AANACA. He was destined to be an alcoholic, I guess. But he knew what I had been through, and he respected that. But my child was a kingdom kid because I gave him Jesus, and he knew. I gave them all Jesus, but Teddy really, really had a personal relationship with God. And he didn't have a choice to learn that Easter speech or to be in the Christmas play or to clean the social hall after events or sing. So if you know his early comedy, it was about him growing up in church. So I am so, so grateful that he grew up to be the man that he was. And it was after sitting down with him and listening to him talk, he started, you know, sharing wisdom with me. I was like, dang, when this kid gets so deep? I mean, my baby is a grown person. So he was kind. He lived his life for the world to see. That was Teddy Ray. But for us, His name is Theodore Rashawn. And as a family, to us, he's Rashawn. So I appreciate each and every person loving him, and even the ones that didn't love him along the way, because I heard about y'all too.
Talk about it, mama. Talk about it, mama. Talk about it, mama. Yeah.
But that's the world. That's the world. I'm not holding it against anyone. Teddy didn't.
No, he didn't.
He used that shit and he built on it. And that's what we need to do. So I'm going to close this out and just say again, I love you. I love you. I just love my son. I will miss him immensely. But the physical, these shells that we have, this is not it. So he's not here. He's here with each and every one of us. And that's how I'm going to be able to get through. So I'm praying for each and every one of you to carry that same thing with you. If you are struggling, we've got to be able to ask for help. You've got to reach out to your fellow, whoever it is. I don't care who it is. Be sure to reach out for help. Share with somebody whatever it is that you're going through. You don't have to do this shit alone. Take care of yourselves. Men, don't be afraid to go to the doctor.
Yes.
Do not get handcuffed with fear. We are under attack. Do not be handcuffed by some stuff that's avoidable. So take a fucking pill. Don't just let it go. Go to the doctor, check on yourself. And for us as women, don't be so consumed caring with your families and the job and the man and all that, that you're not checking on yourself. So that's my message to each of you. Take it however you want. God picks the brightest and the shiniest thing. The brightest and the shiniest things. He don't want no junk. The things that are withering on the vine, guess what? He'll leave it on the vine and try and nourish it some more. Hoping, here's your chance for a new day. Here's some new grace. Here's some new mercy. But the bright and the shiniest ones, he's home. He's home. Where we would all like to be. So fuck all the media noise and nonsense. I got things I could say about that, but I won't. It'll all be worked out in the right time. I love you.
I love you.
I love you. So I appreciate Lou. He called me personally. I'm not hard to find. So folks could have called me and asked or shared or, you know, can we? Lou called me and we had a conversation. He said, is it all right? And because of who he is, I've met his parents. Rashawn has spent holidays at their table. I was okay with that. You feel me? So with all of this, all of the big names of the world, like, oh, what can we do? We're on this platform, we're on that platform. I'm not hard to find. Nobody ever asked me. I believe if those big names and organizations and whatever want to do something, then there needs to be a foundation for struggling comedians. Put your money where your mouth is. We don't need no help to to bury our loved one. You're not going to say, oh, we paid for Teddy's funeral. We paid for flowers. We paid for... Start a foundation. I'm okay if somebody asked me to put his name on it so that comedians, when you can't pay your cell phone bill, when you're struggling getting a gig, let's network and organize. If you got that big money that you say you want to do something with, that's where it needs to go. So I'm going to figure out who has that money and, you know, all these ones that have said, you know, what can we do? Okay, I got an idea. I got an idea. Whatever, what was your number? Let me hear the number first. And then we're going to put something together for this community. For this community.
That's a fact. And I got their number too, mama.
So I love you guys. You guys have just been the world. Just continue to pray for me and my family.
Always.
My daughter, my son, his aunt, cousins, great aunts. Just pray for our entire family. And you guys love each other a little harder. Hug loved ones and let go of bullshit. If it's somebody you haven't talked to your mom in 4 years because, you know, some bullshit, or your dad or whoever it is, don't we have enough stuff that we carry day to day that you just want to not be able to see them, or they become incapacitated where you can't say I love you? There's got to be something that you can say. And I believe that there is something that we can all do. So thank you so much.
Phenomenal job. So proud of you. You did a phenomenal job. That's where Katie got it from. Give it up for moms one more time. Oh, here's some, make sure you get your flowers. This is Brittany. She the one helped me organize all this shit too. She's my right hand. She always look out for me, and she was very close with Teddy as well. You know what I'm saying? This is the friend I said I got that live in the real LA.
Yeah.
That, you know, Teddy and Wasso Equan made sure I know where I was at. You know, so Brittany, you got anything to say?
Yeah, I've been with Lewis for some time now. He introduced me to Teddy. I'm so thankful for that. The first time I met him, we were doing the Young OG show in San Diego, and we had a car karaoke the whole way there and back. And I got videos of that, and I'm just forever grateful. And I was just so thankful for you for bringing Teddy into this world. A lot of people didn't give your son his flowers while he was here, but I'm gonna give you these flowers for your son. Yeah. I was just letting her know while I gave her some love. I know what it feels like to lose a child. I lost two of them the same day, a year apart. So I know her pain, but I know God is gonna give her the strength to get through it. But just know to have to bury your child and your child not bury you, that is something I would never wish on anyone. But mom, we love you. God got you, and Teddy's spirit is forever going to live through you.
For sure. Yeah. Love both of y'all. Thank y'all so much. Love y'all. So this I put this show together, you know what I'm saying? And I couldn't do this shit. You know, I was doing it by, you know, me and Teddy, we were just doing it independently. Every month we did shows in Texas, We done did shows in Denver, all over the United States, you know what I'm saying? We took this shit all over, independently spent our own money, you know what I'm saying, everything. And this show, I was able to partner up with All Def Digital. All Def Digital, give a round of applause to All Def Digital. One thing I learned about Teddy with this experience, as a person, I'm a person that hold grudges, and you know, so it's like, I'm a nigga that you love or hate, you know what I'm saying? And Teddy never held grudges, but you know, he held the grudges, but he still was cordial. You know, so one thing I learned about this experience with Teddy not being here is I learned I gotta work on not holding grudges. And me personally, I never worked with All Def Digital like that, you know what I'm saying? With the misunderstandings, the up and downs when it comes to building a brand and all that. But Teddy kind of felt like sometimes he didn't get the credit he deserved with building up that platform. So it's not, we're not gonna disrespect All Def Digital and their platform, because if it wasn't for them, half of this room or 90% of this room wouldn't have never discovered Teddy Ray. So we're as a unit and as a fan base and as a family, we're gonna respect and put some respect on All Def Digital name. But at the same time, you know, he felt unappreciated at times, and with whatever would happen with individually with Teddy and All Def Digital, at some point it broke his spirit. Yep. It broke his spirit, and he kind of felt discouraged to go out there and try to build up his own platform. And I think that's why this Young OG show and the Cali Kickback mean a lot to him, because those was one of the first platforms he was able to take pride in and say, nah, this, I'm part of that. You know what I'm saying? But a lot of things changed without the years, and me personally, I was holding a grudge on the behalf of my friend Teddy Ray, and with him passing, All Def Digital fam, the squad, they reached out very respectfully, and they offered to partner up with my brand, Do Too Much ENT. They partner up and help me put this show together. Yeah. So I want to give a big shout out to All Def Digital. Because without them, I wouldn't have been able to put this show together, man. It was just too overwhelming for me. And they for sure under new ownership, and it's a lot of rebranding they doing, and they're doing a very good job, and they some good brothers. And I want to bring, if he feel comfortable, I know I'll just put him on the spot, but I just want to bring Cedric to the stage if he in the building. Cedric in the building. Give it up for Cedric one more time. Give it up for Cedric. Well, I just want to say before I hand over you to Mike, we had a phone call, and I really respect you as a man and as a business owner, because you came very respectfully. You know what we've been through, me and Teddy, and what we was building. And as a businessman, you had to make certain decisions or whatever it was, you know what I'm saying? And you doing a phenomenal job. And I respect you, because at the end of the day, you're a black man. No, real shit. I respect you because you're a black man and you're doing something positive and uplifting other comedians. So whatever happened in the beginning, I know, I don't know about that. I was in Oakland at the time. I was mobbing. Yes, that's a fact. So, you know, like mom said, you know what I'm saying, the family probably, you know, whatever they want. I personally request, it'd be dope if Teddy got a mural or something like. You know what I'm saying? I think that'd be dope, you know what I'm saying, for, you know, you just put his face somewhere, because that's what he really cared about. He cared about the people. He cared about L.A., and he did a lot of shit for the people. So at the end of the day, I think that's what you offer, you offered a lot of great things to the table, and I really respect that, and that's the part I respect, and I thank you for partnering up with me and doing this. But you know what I'm saying, Moms made it clear, you know, it's something that we can do as a community and as a culture, as Black people. Let's always come to an understanding. Sometimes I hold grudges because I don't get what I want, and then I don't respect a person as a person, and vice versa. And it sometimes should be business, and then should be personal. I think this was an experience where I learned personally where you gotta put personal and business sometimes together. And Teddy never did that. Teddy has personal relationships and he has business relationships. And his personal life saved his spirit. You know what I'm saying? And I just want to thank the fans. I want to thank everybody for y'all uplifting him because he cared about the people. And I want to thank you, Cedric, and the rest of All Def Digital for coming to us respectfully and saying, let's do something for the people and what Teddy loved. So I want to give credit to you for that, brother.
That was a whole lot there, brother. Appreciate you. Many of you all don't know who I am. I'm actually Cedric Rogers. I'm the CEO, and actually the name of our company is Culture Genesis. We took ownership of All Def November of 2019. And as Lewis mentioned, there was just a whole different leadership that was kind of operating a certain way when it came to All Def. And unfortunately, they went out of business. And so that may be a course, an indication of maybe not doing everything right. So we have investors, as some of you all know, TI is an investor, as well as Baron Davis. And so we are really trying to operate a different way. We do value all of our artists and creators. We're doing some special things. I think we have a few more special things coming. Personally, Teddy Ray was my favorite. And I want to tell you all why. I met Doughboy, and Dough was just like, you know, I got tattoo of All Def on my arm, and I got this, and wildin' out. And he's like, but you gotta meet Teddy. I was like, okay, gotta meet Teddy. So I met Teddy, and so I was raised in a church. I'm from Houston, Texas originally, and I felt that spirit in Teddy the moment I met him. Yeah. And I met his mother, and I felt that spirit in her. And so, you know, I always wanted to do whatever was best for Teddy. But the cool thing about Teddy, he started making it, as y'all saw. He didn't need All Def anymore. He was on MTV. He was doing his, he was getting his projects in. So that was the blessing for Teddy. And I think the goal for Culture Genesis owning All Def is to be a platform for the up-and-coming comedian. And I believe Teddy's mother actually said something I want to follow up on her with her about. It's like building out a foundation. Because I do think that's something that's, you know, really gonna make change. And so we'll look into that because at the end of the day, those are the things that are needed. But in the meantime, I think, you know, what you're gonna see from us is that we have expanded what All Def is, and we're gonna keep doing that. And I do wanna do something in the name of Teddy, because like I said, I got a lot of love for Teddy in my heart. You know, a mural, I don't even know is enough, but that's something we can do though. A mural is not enough when I think about just Teddy. He was just double-cheeked up, you know. That is, you know. We got to acknowledge that. We got to acknowledge that. Like, I'll tell you guys one last story, and I'm going to leave. We have had to go at TikTok to, like, go claim ownership of that for Teddy. Because, see, what happens is all these white kids that are out here flipping around on double-cheeked up, it's all over TikTok. And they don't even know who actually originally did it. I was like, yo, y'all gotta know that was Teddy Ray. So if you guys go look, you'll start to see that we're trying to make sure he's credited for that. Not like they're giving us any money, so let's be real clear, ain't no money. But it's just at least I want his name to be credited, you know? So it's the principle, someone just said, it's the principle of the matter that he is recognized for being that creative and having that much, you know, talent. So with that, you know, that's why our commitment. And if there's anything else we can do, just let us know. Yep. Lewis, last thing, man, you're doing a wonderful job with this. We already talked, we're gonna keep going tomorrow. We wanna keep this going, so let's work together, man.
Give it up for Cedric one more time. And my name is Lewis Belt. We're going to keep this shit lit, man. The Cali Kickback, you know what I'm saying, every week. You know what I'm saying? We're going to keep it lit. Young OG show forever. You know what I'm saying? And we mobbing. I appreciate everybody that came out and really showed y'all love and support. And I want y'all to make it home safe, man. Appreciate y'all. I love y'all, man. I'm gone.
Christmas time, because he always lighting up the trees.
This is my life. This is what I do. He not with it.
You smoking that shit like it's a Virginia Slim, nigga.
Nigga, I'm high as shit.
You just lit it. You 36. I was like, damn, nigga, what you doing out here with all this ass? Double cheeked up on a Thursday afternoon, hella ass, the sun is still out, my nigga, isn't it? Just put a little extra lorries, you know? Do this for extras, you know, this is for mama and them. I'm a dangerous man with some lorries in my pocket. Keep up. I say like I'm like an Emeril Lagasse, but you know, just way more cooler. I don't say bam, I be like cuz. And then I, you know, it's something similar to that. Emeril Lagasse, but crippin'. Chris Brown, Idris Elba, Loretta Devon. It is starring Chris Brown. His last name is alphabetical order. Chris.
That's not how Top Billing works at all.
Always rolling the dice on breath, on life. But I'll let you know this. As much as you want to do and fix things, God is in control. Don't nobody know. I talk to God all day. All day. He don't never tell me what we finna do tomorrow. Nigga, I just talked to you yesterday. Why wouldn't you tell me what's gonna happen tomorrow? Cause that ain't how God work. It's a conversation. You tell your soldiers just as much.